Listen to this very, very carefully, okay? Listen to this very carefully. There's a saying, it says, you do not need to be great to get started. You do not need to be great to get started, but you need to get started to be great. But you need to get started to be great, okay? So you don't need to be great to get started, but you need to get started to be great. I feel like you have to step up at some point. There's a point where you're developing yourself, you're working on yourself, and you're doing that, and you have to do that. But beyond that, you then have to take a step up. You need to then take action. And I'm saying that just by you speaking to 10 people, you could have a massive impact where you get one guy to start thinking about things. That one guy goes and makes a decision that I'm going to start practicing Islam a little bit more. He then starts becoming fully practicing. He then gets married and has kids. It's amazing the impact that you can have from your words. No one starts great. Like, no one's like, okay, I'm just born today, you know, and I'm great, that's it. It's actually a journey that you have to go through, and it starts with you taking the first step. So it's really, really important that you guys focus on taking that first step. You guys focus on actually getting to that place where you've just taken the first step. And really, this is what it's about. It's about the first step. But what I'm saying is that there's different levels, and at some point you have to break through, and you have to go out and start taking action. You have to start impacting people and helping other people. Remember, what Allah loves the most is the one that benefits the people the most, right? So we want to be those people that actually go out, take action, and have an impact in the world. And I'm telling you that there are so many things that you can do to have an impact, and it doesn't need to be like massive. You don't need to say, right, I'm going to quit my job now and I'm going to go and help people in Kashmir or Africa or whatever. This is not about that. The deeds that Allah loves the most are the regular ones, even if they're small. Like, I was talking to one of the brothers at Aira the other day, and he was telling me that they've got this new thing where they're doing dawah over chat. And he was telling me that over chat, they are getting hundreds of shahadas. And I said, like, how long does someone need to volunteer? He said, well, volunteering is 2 hours a week. And I was like, wow, that's amazing. Like, you could just go to them, get on your laptop, and for 2 hours in a week, you just talk to people about Islam, and someone becomes Muslim because of your chat. And that's it. You just give 2 hours a week. And I was like, this is amazing, you know? So there's so many opportunities out there, especially with the kind of world we live in, to go out there and do good and build your akhirah. You know, these are investments for your akhirah. These are investments for your grave. These are the deeds and things that are going to help you. So you want to start to pile them up. You want to start to amass them and try and do as much as you can, especially right now, because right now you might be in a stage of your life where time is actually like abundant for you. It may be that you actually have more time than you're going to have in the future. Da 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 da